don't need the perfect swimming technique to be fast or smooth, but you do need to know that many coaches, and even I, have lied to you. Remember when I said this?
You want to pull water back.
You see, when you swim, you're not really pulling or pushing water. That doesn't even make sense when you're in the water. We say that because it's simple and it kind of works. But the truth, even though it's harder to explain, will help you get a better understanding about swimming.
Welcome to SNT Swimming University.
Today you will learn what really makes you move forward. Should you or should you not do finger weightlifting? Should you focus on improving your reaction time or your entry? Should you specialize in only one event? What makes breaststroke different and how to swim it correctly?
If you want to be faster or smoother, you need to truly understand what makes you move forward. It might be difficult to understand at first, but you're not in swimming high school anymore. You are in
SNT Swimming University.
So buckle up and bear with me. It will make you a better swimmer. I wish I could explain it simply with Newton's laws. You know, you push something, it pushes you back in the opposite direction. But that only happens in two occasions. During the dive and during the turn. The difference is that the blocks and the wall are anchored to the earth. The water is not. So when you pull water, it just moves around your hand and it doesn't move you forward. What makes moving in the water possible is its viscosity. The water's viscosity is the friction between the layers of the water. So when you move your hand while swimming, you form friction in the layers in front of the palm of your hand, which builds pressure. The difference in pressure between the front of your hand and the back of your hand is what in day one we called drag. You know, the same thing that stops you from moving forward. Well, it also tries to slow down your hand, and it is actually very effective at doing so. Check this out. The hand of a good swimmer will remain almost in the same place because it's being stopped by the water's viscosity. Because of the position and the velocity of the hand, it is almost being anchored by pressure drag. As we continue applying force, the arm acts as a lever, moving your body forward. This is one of the two main types of thrust or propulsion we use in swimming. Whew! That was a lot of information. So let's take a 5-second pause while you take a deep diaphragmatic breath.
Professor?
What?
I'm watching this video so I can swim faster. I didn't actually want to learn physics.
Good point, my beautiful underachiever student. Here's how you can use that information.
To swim fast, you need to focus on the middle part of the stroke. This is when your hand should be nearly anchored. This applies to every stroke. At every speed, you anchor your hand here or here and use your hands as a pivot point and your arm as a lever to move yourself forward. In freestyle and backstroke, your feet are also creating pressure and providing stability, especially for the rotation. But it's mainly your hands that help you move forward. Except in breaststroke. Breaststroke is very different, and you'll understand it better in student orientation. So, if your hands are the pivot point, your fingers must be tight. If your fingers are loose, like these, then you won't create as much pressure. I should say that in the past, we mentioned that having your fingers 5 to 8 millimeters apart is optimal for creating more pressure because of the turbulence it creates between the fingers. But it is such a small detail and very hard to apply in real life that you're better off just focusing on keeping your fingers in a very slight curve where you have the most strength. Small details are important, but you need to focus on the basics first, like anchoring your hands. In day 3, we will talk about the other type of thrust we use, especially while doing dolphin kicks.
Since you need to keep your fingers tight
Should you make your fingers stronger to swim faster? Well, you can do this test to find out. Go to the wall and put one foot in front of the other. Put your hand straight up as if you were about to do a freestyle stroke. Now push the wall with your fingers for about 10 seconds. Push it hard, really hard. If your fingers bend, then you might consider strengthening them. But most of you will feel your core and shoulders working hard, which means you probably have enough strength in your fingers to pull your body forward in the water. So it's better to work on stability and strength of your core and shoulders. You'll never guess who has the fastest reaction times. Well, according to this study, in 2017, in the Budapest World Championships, the fastest reaction times were the 50 butterflyers. The backstrokers have a different start, so the reaction time is measured a little bit different. And although there is a significant difference between events, there wasn't really a significant difference between swimmers in the qualifying heats, the semifinals, and the finals. Meaning that there are more important things to focus on than your reaction time. For example, how far you jump, the angle of entry, and the actual swim, of course. That is, assuming you have an average reaction time for your event. For example, my average reaction time in college for the 100 freestyle was 0.68, which is on par with the 100 freestylers from the World Championships. Improving it wouldn't have made much of a difference to my performance. However, if my reaction time was particularly bad, like 0.9, then I could have definitely improved 0.2 of a second without that much effort. If you're a sprinter, should you improve your endurance? And if you're a distance swimmer, should you improve your sprinting? Sometimes there are very talented people that can seemingly swim any event and win. In 1912, one swimmer won 100% of the female swimming events. Her name? Fanny Durack. Total number of events? One, the 100 freestyle. But after that, she went on to break every freestyle world record there was. She was like a Katie Ledecky and a Sara Sjostrom put together. Professor, does that mean that I can train for distance and sprint and be the best at both? Not really. Nowadays, it is widely accepted that even the best swimmers will sacrifice explosiveness if they mainly train for long distance events, or will lose some endurance if they train mainly for power. That is not to say that you should never train distance or sprints. Different types of training have their place in specific parts of the season. Back to our point, rather than focusing on one event that you like, it is better to know yourself and see if you have a predisposition for sprinting events or longer distance events, and train accordingly. In any case, sometimes it is fun to compete or practice your worst stroke or event, and can even be beneficial for some aspects of your best events like coordination, balance, or creating stability by developing stroke-specific muscles. For me, competing in breaststroke was extremely fun because no one expected anything from me. With time, I became fairly good at sprinting breaststroke, which helped me swim the individual medley faster. Learning what to focus on is just as important as learning what not to focus on. It's all about the smart allocation of resources. Speaking of which, what do you think is more important in breaststroke? The kick or the pull? In fact, the legs and the kick contribute as much as the arms do to the overall propulsion. So you have two sources of propulsion in breaststroke that each work better if the other one is not. Like two pistons. This is the best explanation of breaststroke I have read. Pull when the legs are streamlined, and kick when the upper body is streamlined, explains Russell Mark. Talking to Miguel, our breaststroke expert, we concluded that it is true that propulsion of the kick should initiate after the pull is finished. But not everyone kicks exactly when the upper body is streamlined. Some of the best breaststrokers kick a little before, when the arms are just shooting forward, which brings us back to where we started. The perfect swimming technique is not the same for everyone, but the fundamentals of swimming remain consistent across the board. Miguel is actually the one bringing you these amazing shots of his teammates on Team Elite Aquatics. I think you'd enjoy following him. His Instagram technique is just as good as his breaststroke. Before you go, remember your homework. Next time you swim, think about anchoring your hands to move forward. Focus more on the fundamentals of swimming, like creating less drag and more thrust, and less on the small details, like reaction time or finger separation. Try to get better at your worst events, even if it's just for fun. Having fun is important too. If you want to get better at breaststroke, focus on your upper body first, and then your legs. If you want to continue watching Swimming University classes, click on this playlist. If you want to attend one of our in-person swimming camps, or you want to buy a swim cap, or buy a training plan, visit our webpage, skillswimming.com, or click here. See you there. Swim fast.